Governor Brown is out tonight with a plan to change the pension benefits for government workers in our state. KCRA3's David Bienick is live at the state capitol with what's in the plan and why the governor says this is needed. David?
Yeah, good afternoon, Edie. This plan by the governor has been in the works for months, but when it finally came out today, it made bigger changes and applied to a lot more workers than some people were expecting.
Governor Brown said today California has no choice, that this state can no longer afford its current government pensions.
We've got to take some very strong action.
Among the governor's proposals, raising the retirement age from 55 to 67 for most future state workers and requiring all workers, both future and current, to pay at least half their pension cost.
And that is the most immediate and the biggest change that will make our pension plans more solvent.
The governor also wants to convert to hybrid pensions, which combine a traditional guaranteed monthly benefit with 401k-style investments, subject to the ups and downs of the market.
I went as far as I thought the courts would allow us.
The governor says this will save about $900 million a year, or about half what the state spends on pensions. What's more, the governor also wants these changes to apply to local government and school workers as well. Such constitutional changes mean the governor will not only need the legislature's approval, but voters as well.
I've tried to do something that's legal, that'll save a hell of a lot of money going forward, and I think is fair.
So what's next? Well, the governor plans to submit his pension plan to the Joint Assembly Senate Conference Committee. But I asked the governor today, what if the legislature doesn't go along with his pension plan? Would he consider submitting it directly to voters? And he didn't rule that out. Live at the state capitol, David Bienick, KCRA3 reports.